Today's an easy day. I'm running wires in the F-150, and we got the second batch of explosion shirts, and we're getting those shipped out, as well as the commemorative limited edition wall placards.
Oh, yeah, still hitting dicks.
Amplifiers produced by Soundman Enterprises, Inc., Mobile Solutions, CT Sounds, and Extreme Autosports.
Whistle while you jerk.
And to think, when I was young, my parents were worried because I would always be talking to myself about dicks all day. They thought I would grow up to be sucking dick for cocaine. But instead, I'm in here talking about dicks by myself. And sanding dicks for cash to buy cocaine with.
Can I help? Like a salt shaker, too hard, get it up till you can't pump no more.
My mother would be proud.
Take it to the phone, baby, bounce, big and bounce, huh? It's on you, shout it, you can twerk in your skirt.
Just kidding, I've never tried cocaine. I have tried to smuggle it here from Mexico, though, but it went wrong because I tried to smuggle a kilo in Rafa's mom's fart box. And she blew a gasket.
Whatever, you shut the fuck up.
She blew cocaine all in the inside of the car and her ass was numb for 7 days. She didn't feel a thing. When I was...
It doesn't matter what you did, Doug.
Say,
got him again!
Got him! Make that ass clap. Niggas in the clue, spinning dudes when it's fat. Thinking real fine, standing by nine.
Today I also have to loom up a set of RCAs and two sets of speaker wire and some remote wire into one nice loom and run it in the F-150 from the head unit to the amp rack. I have these wires loomed up in a professional looking loom. Look at it. Damn! Now I just need to take my truck apart and slap it in real quick. This is called the tucking stuff. You just tuck the fucking wire under the carpet. Shove it in the side. These wires will come in right up here. Now I can't remove my theft-proof amp rack. Oh, this is gonna be a bitch right now. Such a good theft-proof idea, I can't even get it out. Fuck. And I also just realized I fucked myself. Again. This Audison AP8.9 bit is a processor with a built-in amplifier, but it doesn't have any pre-outs for my Macintosh amp. Which means I have to hook the pre-outs up to the head unit, but that means my mids won't be processed through the processor. Which means I need to buy the new head unit I've had my eye on. Which will give me optical out of the head unit to my Audison processor. And it has a clean set of pre-outs I can use for. With this amp setup, my goal is to dramatically increase the sound quality of the front stage. So, to do that, I'll need to get the mids off of the D-class amplifier in the Audison processor, put them on the A-class Macintosh. But they'll need their own clean pre-out that we can still tune. This Sony deck has a super clean preamp output and an EQ, so we could tune the mids first. Since that's going to play the majority of the bandwidth, then we could tune the tweeters around it, keeping everything processed and active. Class A, B on the mids, Class D on the tweets, and sub. Damn! How's that for only $1,500 for the deck? Which means I need to release a new product. Whenever there's a problem, there's always a $1,500 solution. So for a limited time only, starting tomorrow, for one day only, we have a new product, which will be announced tomorrow. Wait till you see it. It's new!
Whoa! This one's got a little butthole in it. That's extra. Whoever got this one, you have to send me PayPal for an extra $15. Extra butthole is extra. Yo, you want that butthole? You're paying extra. If you want the...
I'm gonna run this behind this metal rail because there's a couple loops I could use to zip tie the loom. That way I could keep it away from all of this factory wiring. I have a power wire that comes up through the firewall for the Audison processor. And I don't want these shitty ass Audison RCAs to pick up any engine noise.
This will be interesting because the way we could set this up is we could use the RCA pre-out for the Macintosh amp, and we could tune the mids through the head unit by hooking up our RTA and analyzing the output. Then we could use the optical output to go into the Audison processor, which then will be processed within the processor. We could adjust that also with the RTA. RTA tune the tweeters and the rear speakers. And we'll have more power hooked up to our tweeters because we could bridge channels 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 to the right and left tweeters. So we're upping our tweeter output by adding more power, and we're adding more power to our mids, and we're upgrading to a Class AB amplifier for our mids. The only thing I'm worried about is that the optical output might not change volume as I turn the head unit up and down, which will cause a mismatch in the frequencies between the tweeter and the mids. If the frequencies of the tweeter and the mids mismatch, it could heat up the coil. It better not heat up on Taco Tuesday, because if Rafa's mom busts a fart in the cab, it could ignite the fuse. I can't wait to get this head unit. I gotta quit digging around.
Thank you, again, for your support.
My wiring is ran from the front all the way back to the amp rack. The nice small heads on these Audison RCAs fit my amp rack perfectly. Piece of cake. Next, I need to work on running power and ground for the amps. Thank you guys so much for always watching. Leave a comment. Let me know what limited edition product you'd like to see in tomorrow's episode. And make it something good, because it has to sell. I need to generate $1,500 to buy myself a Sony optical head unit. It's going to be so nice. The head unit, not the product I'm going to come out with. Let me know what you guys think about today's episode. I'll see you guys tomorrow for a fresh new episode of Amplified. Support Amplified by buying iPad dash kits and Soundman merch at soundmanca.com. Become a car audio master with the tools and trainings available for mobile solutions at mobilesolutions-usa.com. Receive a discount on all the best car audio equipment from CT Sounds by using coupon code Soundman at ctsounds.com. And come down to see me and Rafa at Extreme Autosports in Santa Clarita and get great deals on audio and performance equipment and installation.